Dan Howe is the president and co-founder of PTI Securities. He joins us from the CME Group. Wayne Wilbanks is chief investment officer at Wilbanks Smith and Thomas Asset Management. He oversees about $1.5 billion in assets. Wayne is in Virginia Beach, Virginia. I want to start in Chicago, though. Dan, let me ask you about Disney earnings. I mean, we were talking about this during the break a little bit. We didn't need it after Cisco, did we?
No, we certainly didn't. I mean, Cisco was a major disappointment today. And it actually hit a real hot button, too. I mean, they specifically mentioned that their sales to government agencies were way down. And we all knew this was coming, but this is really the first evidence that it's actually in place, that governments, at least state and local, are not buying.
Wayne, let me ask you your take on, before we get into Disney, and I do want to get into it, you have something to say about it. Cisco really still the big driver of the red arrows that we're looking at in the trade today, down 16%. What do you think about the news?
Well, I mean, I think the news is, I agree with Dan about the government spending getting cut back, but I think people need to anticipate this ahead, because you're going to see, as you saw in the budget news today, there's going to be a lot of cutbacks coming on the government, state and federal level. So this may be the tip of the iceberg for a lot of these tech companies that sell a lot into this space. Also, the stock was ahead of itself going into this, so it reacted negatively, just opposite of what Intel did when they pre-announced. They actually were stable. So
Wayne, do you see the pullback in Cisco as a buying opportunity?
We actually, I was talking to our analysts today about under 20. I think you have to look at it. They're trading at 12 times next year's earnings. It fits our theme that you want to own these big, large, high-quality U.S. companies that are trading very, very cheap. So we would use these kind of scare opportunities as buying opportunities.
But what about Wayne, tech across the board? I mean, if you point out the government's going to be pulling back on contracts, probably not just in tech, but in all different kinds of sectors, even if Cisco's a buying opportunity after a 16% drop, is everything else, do you get even more cautious than on everything else?
Well, it's more the other side of the equation. It's the $2 trillion that's sitting on corporate balance sheets that we think make up that difference. There's a huge cycle that's going to last several years for small companies like ours to big companies. So I think that should be able to take up the slack from the government spending.
We heard, Dan, from Joe Saluzzi about the fact that high-frequency traders don't like surprises. What do you think as far as you real-life people traders? I mean, does the market not like to see this kind of thing, earnings released before the schedule?
Oh, yeah, the guys in the option pit were probably really surprised by this, and they definitely don't like surprises. I mean, they could have been into something knowing full well that they had 3, 4, 5 minutes to get covered, and all of a sudden they're not. I mean, there's a lot of people either made money by mistake or lost money by mistake today.
Hey, Wayne, let me ask you about your take on Disney, because we were talking about it a little bit during the break here. What do you think about the company? You gave us your take on Cisco. Obviously, it's a very different story here, but still it's part of the TMT sector.
Right. I think the quality of these earnings are still exceptionally good. And so even if you miss and lower your revenue forecast by 1%, we got to understand the valuations on most of these companies are super cheap. So, you know, so the top line drops 1%. I think the longer term story is Disney's brand is huge. ESPN is on fire right now. If you look at what they're doing on the website, as well as the certainly the cable side, I just think it's a tremendous franchise. However, the parks business is what you should watch carefully, because that will be affected by weaker consumer spending as we get into next year if sentiment drops. But I think you got to be a long-term investor on something like Disney.
All right, so let's just broaden it out a little bit. Obviously, Disney is our big story. But Wayne, I mean, you're very bullish on the income side of the ledger at this point. So overall, you see what more gains to come here?
Right. Well, I think the corporate credit area, clearly the great earnings that we're all talking about, even though they're not quite as good as everybody wants, is great for balance sheets and income statements. So everything from high yield junk bonds to regular corporate credit, these companies are piling up the cash. So what you're seeing, it's great to be a debtor to these companies. And so we continue to like the coupon income. Okay. Especially in the high yield space.
All right, guys, we got to run. Wayne Wilbanks, thank you so much. Dan Howe, thanks so much, guys. I'm